Hello everyone. Now we are going to solve the problem on the truss element. So we can see the truss element which are connected with the three elements, and at the node 1, node 2, node 3 there is an fixed end, and we have additional the angle for the element 3, that is 45 degrees, is given in the question. So this is very important to understand here why this angle 45 degree is mentioned in the question. So we have manually solved many problems on the truss element. So this will be considered as an important problem in the finite elements method. So after that, so here one thing with the concept of this truss element is where the load is applying at the node 2. When you apply the node 2, what were the deformation at each node you are going to be calculate in this problem. So wherever there is a load, there will be a deformation at different nodes also. So at what nodes, what are the different types of displacement you are going to be calculated by using the finite elements method, you have to obtain the deformations. So now let us read the diagram here. Let us understand the diagram first. So here there are three elements which are given. This is an element 1 and element 2, element 3. And for the element 1, it is an perpendicular where the angle is 90 degree for the element 1 when you taken this as an reference line. And whereas in the element 2, that angle is 0 degree. It is an parallel to the axis. Whereas the element 3, which is making an angle of 45 degree, it means that you need to calculate the theta for all the different types of elements. So one by one I will solve the problem. Now for the plane stress shown above, so this is a plane stress which have been given in the question. So it is a 2D element where the load is given as 1000 kilonewton. So this P as 1000 kilonewton, and capital L, the length for the element 1, that is given as 1 meter. So remember, only this length is given, the vertical length is given for the element 1. And E is equal to the Young's modulus. It is a material property. That value is given 210 gigapascal. And the area for the element 1 and 2, so element 1 and 2 having a same area. Okay, so that value is given as 6 into 10 power of minus 4 meter square. And for the element 3, having a different value, that is 6 under root of 2 into 10 power of minus 4 meter square for the element 3. Okay, so now we can say that all the values are in meter. So here it will be an meter we need to convert. So gigapascal is nothing but 10 power of 9 pascal, where 1 pascal is equal to newton per meter square, and the area is given in meter square. For both the elements are given, so you need to calculate the displacement in meter. Okay, so after understanding the question, here we are having three elements. So for the element 1, this element 1 having two nodes, the connectivity table from 1 to 2, it is connecting from 1 to 2 or 2 to 1, the connectivity for the element 1. So for that, in the truss element, as you know, you need to calculate the cos theta. See, first I will write for the stiffness matrix for element 1, where K is equal to, it is AE by L in the matrix. So it is L square LM, again LM M square. So minus L square, minus M square, sorry, minus LM, minus LM, M minus M square. So again in the diagonal it will be same. So it will be a symmetry matrix. Again here it will be same, L square LM, LM M square. So this is the stiffness equation for the and truss element which you we know already. Okay, so now you need to calculate the length. So what is L? L is nothing but the length for the element 1. Okay, so L and M is nothing but, it is a sine theta we have taken, and L is nothing but cos theta we have taken in the previous problem. Okay, so now what is cos theta? Cos theta is nothing but it is x2 minus x1 by l1 which are taken by taking the coordinate system at 1 and coordinate system at 2 and 3, this equation you have solved. Now in this question, what is the priority for this question is where the angle we can directly take for this equation. Suppose for the element 1, where the theta it will be taken as 90 degree, theta it will be 90 degree for the element 1, because that value, that element is then perpendicular, so the length it will be 90 degree. And if you have taken theta as 90 degree and their length L will be so cos theta is nothing but it is 0, cos 90 degree it will be 0, whereas m sin 90 degree that will be 1. Okay, so now you can directly calculate that L and m by taking the theta value. So after that, again we are following the same method where we have to calculate the stiffness matrix for the element 1, that is K1. So for the element 1 we are calculating, so where AE by L, so area for the element 1, that is 6 into 10 power of minus 4 into Young's modulus, 210 into 10 power of 9, divided by the length for the element 1. So I will keep this in hand, so you can see here length for the element 1. So that length is given as 1 meter. Length is mentioned in the question, so that will be 1 meter divided by, now in the matrix we have to write in the matrix where we have L square LM. Okay, so L value is 0, okay, and M value, LM again it will be 0 0 0. Now LM it will be 0, m square is nothing but 1, again LM 0, m square it will be 1, so minus m square, so it will be minus 1. So now again 0 0 0 0, now LM again it will be 0, so m square minus 1, LM 0, m square plus 1. So this is the stiffness matrix for the element 1. So for the element 1, what are the displacement at element 1? So we can write the displacement at 1 and 2, where horizontal displacement it will be u1, vertical displacement it will be v1. At the node 2 also it will be horizontal u2, vertical v2. And at the 3, so actually 3 is an inclined one, so where horizontal it will be u3 and this is an vertical v3. So totally 6 deformation we have, or the displacement. So now I can write the displacement here for the element 1. It will be from connectivity from 1 to 2. So u1 v1, u2 v2. Similarly in the row, u1 v1, u2 v2. Okay, say this is equation number 1. Again we'll go for, similarly I will calculate for K2, where the area is same, 10 minus 4, and the Young's modulus is also remain same, divided by the length for the element 2. Okay, this length, the length for the element 2, so that length for the element 2 again it will be same, actually it is given in the question also, here it is an L again, length for the element 2, so that will be again 1. Now in the stiffness matrix, so here we can obtain L square is nothing but, so for the element 2, what is the angle for the element 2? Theta. Okay, for theta there it is 0 degree, and L we can obtain if cos 0 means 1 degree, and where m sine degree, sine theta, sine 0 degree, that is equal to 0. Okay, now where L square is nothing but 1 and LM 0, again L square minus L square, so minus 1, 0, so 0 0 0 0, so minus 1, 0 1, 0 0 0 0 0, So just I am substituting the L and M value in the equation. So here, what will be the displacements at 2? So displacement at 2, here it we have the displacement from 3 to 2 or 2 to 3. So U2, V2, U3, V3 are the displacement. U2, V2, U3, V3. Again here, U2, V2, U3, V3. So say this is number equation number 2. Again, we will calculate for the element 3, K3. So now, before calculating K3, write down the theta value. So where we have the inclination for the element 3, that angle is given, that is 45 degree. So 45 degree. Now, theta for L is nothing but cos theta. Cos 45 degree, that value is 1 by root 2. And M, again 1 by root 2, sine 45 degree. So now we will calculate again K3. So area for the element 2, that value is 6 under root 2 into 10 power of minus 4. So that value, area for the element 2 is different. 6 under root 2 into 10 power of minus 4 is given. So into the Young's modulus, 210, 10 power of 9 divided by. So length for the element 3. So the length for the element 3, it will be length 1 by root 2. So it will be root 2. 1 by root 2 is nothing but root 2. Okay. So 1 by root 2. After that, this is L square. So L square is nothing but it will be obtained. Here we can do one thing. So these two will get cancelled. So remaining again 6 into 10 power of 4, 210 into 10 power. So we got the same value as in the previous cases. So here 1 by 2 is nothing but 0.5 minus 0.5 minus 0.5. 0.5, 0.5, minus 0.5, 0.5. So again minus 0.5, minus 0.5, 0.5, 0.5. Minus 0.5, 0.5, 0.5, 0.5. So this is an element 3. Okay. So when you made the L square, okay, so 1 by root 2 square, we will obtain 0.5. So we have generally all the, this is LM. Again, minus L square, minus LM. So we will obtain this equation. So this L is nothing but the length of the element 1. So length for the element 1, for the case 1, L is given, mentioned in the question. Okay, so L is 1 meter. For the element 2, we have obtained 1 meter. So that 1 we have mention here. For the element 3, this is 1 by root 2. So 1 by root 2 we have taken here. So after that, again the next method to calculate the global stiffness matrix. Where K is equal to K1 plus K2 plus K3. So now again we are calculating the stiffness matrix for the all the three elements. So that is called as global stiffness matrix. So we obtained 6 into 10 power of 4 and 210 into 10 power of 9. So this term is common in all the three elements. So here also it is common, because under root of 2 it will be get cancelled. So it will be same for all the three elements. So after this calculation, 2 into 10 power of 2 into 10 power of minus 4 into 210 into 10 power of 5. So we will obtain 1260 into this 10 power of 9 minus 10 power of 4, we will obtain 10 power of 5. So this value will obtain. So I will take that value as a common here. So 1260 into 10 power of 5. Again, we'll make a matrix where all the displacement which will be comes under this matrix. So now we have 6 displacements. So I will write all the displacements, that is U1, V1, u2 v2, next u3 v3. Similarly, in the row also you have to write u1 v1, u2 v2, u3 v3. And always remember, while while making the global stiffness matrix, so it will be a symmetry matrix. So you can make the half of that only. So remaining half you can reduce that work. Okay. So generally, while making the elimination method, we required all the elements, because sometimes it may take this value. So the remaining value will may be this value. That time you have to remember what will be the next equation here, that you have to remember. So after that, so now again we will go for the and calculating the global stiffness matrix. So here at the first row and first column, so that is u1 u1, so u1 u1 is having 0 at the element 1. Similarly, the same value will obtain at the element 3 also, because element 3 it is connected from u1 v1, next u3 v3, that connectivity table for the element 3. So how it will be means, so here we can see from 1 to 3 it is connected, means the displacement from u1 v1 next u3 v3, so the displacement will be this one. Now again write down u1 v1 in the row also, u3 v3. So we are here now. So there u1 v1 we said it is 0 at the element 1, so here again 0.5 is at the element 3, so I can write 0.5. So now second, u1 v1, so u1 v1 is 0 at the element 1, u1 v1 again 0.5. now u1 u2 is 0, u1 u2, so no elements here, so that will be 0 again, here also it will be 0. Now u1 u3, so u1 u3, that is minus 0.5. again u1 u3, so minus 0.5. so these two we got from the element 3. Okay, 0.5 is from the element 3. So similarly you have to calculate for all the elements in this method. So now v1 u1, so v1 u1, that is 0. So look at the here also, what is that, v1 u1, so that is 0.5, so it will be 0.5 here. So like that you have to calculate. So this calculation I have made it separately, so that value I am going to write now. So 1.50 minus 1, 0.5 minus 0.5, so now here it will be 1 0 minus 1 and 0. Next, at this row v2, where 1 0 0, again zero, 1.5 it is, 1.5 0.5, so last it is 0.5. so this value we can obtain. So in the symmetry means here it will be 0. Okay, so 0.5, so 0, zero. So now I have made this element as a symmetry matrix. I took some time to arrange this one. So here these elements we have obtained, again I have made into the symmetry matrix, or you can individually manually you can calculate all these value. So it becomes a global stiffness matrix, where I will call this as equation number 4. Now after that, the important thing is to make the formation of the finite elements equation, FE equation, where K U is equal to F, where stiffness matrix K is equal to force per unit deformation. Now we can write this K value here. Displacement, all the displacement in the above. zero point five Sometimes the maybe a small digit cannot be changed, so while calculating be careful. So after this, what will be the deformation? Same deformation you have to write in the matrix form. So u1 v1 u2 v2 u3 v3. Similarly, the force. So for the truss element, the force element will be 2 at each nodes. So suppose consider at the node 1, so there will be two forces are act. One is F1x, that is a horizontal force, another F1y. So one indicates node 1 and direction is x and y. Similarly, at the element 3, it will be F3x, F3y. At 2, it will be F2x plus F2y. Okay, now at the node 1, these two are related to node 1. So F1x, F1y, F2x, F2y, F3x, F3y. So after that, the important thing is to apply the boundary conditions. Applying the boundary conditions. So again, we have to study the diagram. So what are the boundary conditions here? So look at the diagram. So here this element 1, it is rigidly fixed, so there will be no deformation either in the horizontal or vertical. So where u1 and v1 both is equal to 0, right? So u1 v1 is equal to 0. Now look at the second node, where we have the roller support, means it can make the deformation in the horizontal, but there will be no deformation in the vertical. So there at the node 2, v2 is equal to 0, no vertical deformation, there will be an horizontal deformation. Now at the 3, also similarly it is an roller support, where we have the horizontal deformation, no vertical deformation. It means V3 is also 0. So these are the deformation boundary conditions. Now after that, again we have to look at the load, where the load is applying in an horizontal axis at node 2. So this value, it will be taken as F2x. The load, it will be in the point of F2x, that is 1000 kilonewton is mentioned. Okay, that is a given value in the question. So where P is equal to 1000 kilonewton. So after this boundary condition, we have to apply in the same finite elements equation. So again, I will in the same equation I will continue, where V1 U1 is 0. So this will give at 0. Next V2 becomes 0, V3 becomes 0. So you need to calculate just U2, U3, you have to calculate. These are the two unknown displacement you are going to calculate now. Now the force, all the forces, it will get 0, because we have only one force, that is 2 at the force of 2x. So here it is here. So that is 1000 kilonewton is given. So what is the value here? We have 1260 into 10 power of 5. This again same value I have written it. So 10 power of 5, kilo is nothing but 10 power of 3. So inside it will be 10 power of 3. So if I made 10 power of 5, so what will be 10? It will be inside. So 10 is there inside the matrix. So this becomes cancel, get cancelled. Okay. So now after that, by the elimination method, so this first row and their first column, it will get cancelled. Again, the last row and their last column, it will get cancelled. So similarly, this second row and their second column, it will get cancelled. Now, the fourth row and this is an fourth column, again it will get cancelled. So we have cancelled first, second, fourth and sixth, all the rows and column are cancelled. So what is the remaining after cancellation? We have to make in the another matrix. So here it is 1260 as it is. Now the inside it will be 1 minus 1 and 0 0. Now the value it will be U2, sorry, one more it will be there. So what is there here? 1 minus 1 minus 1 1.5. So this value are the remaining, and U2 U3 is equal to, here it is an F2Y and F3X. Okay, so as I said you, it is U2 that is given as 1 into 10 power of 5. So it is inside, it is an 10. So this 10 power of 5 which you already cancelled. So here it will be 10 power of 5. So this these two value are the remaining in the force. Okay, so now 1260, 1 minus 1 minus 1 1.5. So the displacement U2 U3 is equal to 10 F3X. So that is again 0. As I said you initially, there is no another forces, so it will be 0. So you can make a equation now, 1260 U2 minus 1260 U3 is equal to 10. Again second equation, 1260 minus 1260 U2 plus, so this 1260 into U3 we have to do. So this 1260 into 1.5 we will obtain 1890 U3 is equal to 0. And now from this equation we have to eliminate these two. So these two will get cancelled. Now we will obtain the value of U3. So 1890 minus 1260. 630 U3 is equal to 10 we will obtain. So U3 is equal to 10 by 630. So 15.87 into 10 power of minus 3 in meter. Okay, so this is the displacement at 3. Similarly, we can calculate the displacement at 2 by substituting the any one equation. So 1260 U2 minus 1260 U3 is equal to 0, is equal to 10. Okay, so 1260 U2 keep as it is. So 1260 into U3, 1260 into U3 is 15.87 into 10 power of minus 3. Please subscribe the channel and